Welcome, welcome. All right, today we're going to tell you how we made our 2018 VNL 780 Volvo truck into a micro tiny house. Okay, you've heard of tiny houses, right? They're popular. But when you put it inside of a semi and you put two people in it, and this is not a stretch out camper, this is just a regular old sleeper truck, it's beyond tiny, it's micro, okay? So we're gonna show you how we have our truck arranged. We've been on the road for about 18 months now, and we figured out some tricks and tips to help it feel more like a tiny house and more like a home, how we cook and everything out. So here's the layout of what we've come up with. We're not saying it's the best solution, but it works for us. So hopefully this gives you some ideas. All right, guys, so I'm gonna try to start at the driver's seat and go up around and then back down and to the back to give you a quick overview. This is not gonna be an in-depth video completely because we have lots of other videos like comfort in the driver's seat and how to get better sleep on the road that will tell you more details about the truck. So this is just a brief overview of how we've made it as an overview of how the things fit together. So up here in the top cabinet, we have these tote boxes. These work great. We have some extra things in there, Pepto-Bismol, extra bars of soap, some chapstick, toothpaste, things like that in there. We also have paper logs, so if the e-log goes down, we have backups in there. We also have our junk box. Everybody has a junk drawer at home, so we have our junk box right here. We have an extra inverter. This is just a really small inverter, just enough to run our water source, so if the big inverter goes out, we still have water. All right, now down into the driver's seat. You can see up here, this compartment, we have just tissues, shop towels. We have our food snack cabinet. Here's the driver's seat. We use cups. We don't like to use bottles. That's too much waste for us. We don't like waste. Like I said, in our other videos, we like to be careful about our imprint. So in the driver's seat, we got a gallon of water. We fill that up with our water source. All right, so moving right along, we got the CB. Can't forget the CB because, you know, right now we're filming this video because the highway shut down. There's a 10-mile backup. So we thought we'd make you a video. All right, so you might be wondering what's up here. We'll go over that in another video. That's what do you do if there's not a bathroom, okay? We got some other stuff in here. We got some cough drops, some Altoids, different things like that. And we're gonna pop it up here. We got Lily's food. We got a Tupperware container, airtight. We got Lily's food in there. We got our vitamins because it's important to stay healthy. There's a video about that, how we stay healthy on the road. Check that out. Got the purse up there, and we also have some extra bath towels in the back. All right, now moving right on down. In the passenger seat, we got Lily. She's taking a nap. She's not too impressed with the highway shutdown.
They ask you how you are, and you just have to say that you're fine when you're not really fine, but you just can't get into it because they would never understand.
Yeah. Underneath here, you can see we store boots. It's a little bit hard to tell, but Scott has his boots underneath there, right here. We have a floor mat in here that's a little bit, it's for your house actually. We put it in here so that way it helps keep our truck clean. We can scrub our boots off faster. And then we have our water source. So we talked about this in Trucker's Kitchen and the dish one. And it just slides up underneath there, keeps the water hot. We have Lily's leash and stuff over here in the door. And then back here we have my coat hanging up. We just have a hanger, it's hanging up there. Scott's coat's here. And we rotate them depending who's driving. Scott's gonna be driving here soon, so his coat's down, my coat's tucked away. Back here, we have a little table. If you check out Trucker's Kitchen, you'll see what this table's about. All right, now we're gonna move all the way up again. All right, up here, this is our wardrobe section. So you see these little totes? This can fit a week's worth of clothes in it. So this has Scott's clothes in it. And then there's a shower bag in there next to it. It's part of the Trucker's Kitchen. We have our microwave. Now this is our big reveal. This is our water source. Y'all are gonna think it's crazy, okay? This is really a wardrober, but okay, I don't know if you've heard hangers banging around in a truck. Quite annoying, does not work well. Do not put hangers in the truck, does not work. They end up on the bottom of there. So what we did is we have this 5-gallon water jug. Yeah, it looks kind of weird. It's all strapped in there, but it has a pump head on the top of it. All right, the pump head is awesome. It just allows it to plug back in here, the outlet, and we can pump water right out. So let me just show you what that looks like real fast, because some of you are probably like, what? This is what we do. We get our gallon jug, push the little red button, water comes out. Look at that. So we have 5 gallons of water on the truck at all times. We actually bring 6, because we drink 6 gallons of water a week, so we have this extra one when we start the week off. And another reason we do it, guys, is because of the savings. It cost us $1.75.
$1.75.
$1.75 for 6 gallons worth of water. You can't even buy a case of water, like a 40-pack case, for $3 or less. Especially if you're buying at the truck stops, it's $5.99 a case. So $1.75. We have fresh water. We're not having waste plastic bottles. This works best for us. And right here, this is our recycle can. We like to recycle. So we have a regular trash bag hooked up here. We just put a hole in it. Scott throws his cans in there. Make sure you keep that off to the side. Don't let your cans get down there. They get smashed. They make a hole in the bag. Big mess. And then we got the Dr. Pepper from the fridge. That's our reserve spot for Dr. Pepper. And down here at the very bottom, I know it's going to be tough for y'all to see. I'll try to pull it out here. And you'll see this little guy in some of our Trucker's Kitchen videos. We have a convection oven down here. It fits perfect. We keep it in the bottom cabinet because, yes, they do get hot. We can just slide it in and out, well ventilated underneath there. And we don't have to worry about it touching anything and getting anything hot or melting. Never had a problem. Over here, you guys saw it in the Keep It Clean video for our truck cleaning. We have our trash bags and whatnot. All right, so now we're going to just... Scott's going to circle around behind me. He's being the cameraman today. We got the bed made up. And if you watch the sleep video, how to sleep better in a truck, you'll see this curtain. Okay, we have a curtain. That's what we have pulled across here. We use a top bunk for storage, guys. So we bring a lot of our stuff in totes, and then I empty the totes, put it up there, put the pillows up there. We have our bed. We keep, you know, some oils and different sleep stuff up top there. So that's pretty much bed. Bed's simple, right? And then we're gonna go to this cabinet. All right, here's my shelf for my clothes and my shower bag. And then inside of here is where we keep some of the food. Great tip real fast on how to store bananas. If you get a bowl or a colander and you put a towel on the bottom of it or grippy stuff, these bananas have been riding around for 5 days in the truck. They are not beat up at all. They used to get really beat up, but it works great. The bowls don't tip over. You keep everything nice and aligned. And then here we have our electric skillet. You all know about the electric skillet. We got a cutting board. We have the pan for in the convection oven. So that's pretty much between the convection oven, the electric skillet, and the microwave. You can really see there's Scott's muffins. Those are not mine. This is mine. Look, I get like trail mix and stuff, okay? Scott's muffins, mine. So I'm the healthier person. Scott likes his glutens. All right. And then here's more food. The awesome thing about this truck is I love the drawers. They really help organize your food better. So here's some of our food. And then here is my spice and tea cabinet. Because I do cook from scratch, you know, I use a lot of raw ingredients. So I have my nice organic seasonings in here. I also have my teacup. So I have different kinds of teas put in the pouches. We have coconut oil, all kinds of little things in there. So that's our spice cabinet, basically. And then we got a refrigerator down here. Refrigerator's awesome. Jam-packed full of food. All fresh stuff in there, raw ingredients. Don't forget the Dr. Pepper, that's not raw though. It's cool. All right guys, so I forgot this small area because either I was standing in it or Scott was standing in it. So you'll see we have a rug here. The floor does get really cold in the wintertime, so I do suggest a rug. It also helps you from having to, you know, mop the floors as much because there is no mopping the floor. It's wiping it up by hand. So many videos you will see this block. Scott made this for me. I'm short, but it has a million and one purposes in our truck and we use it for everything. So it's just a 2x4 little wooden scrap box that Scott made, and I threw some carpet over it. That way Lily doesn't slide around when she tries to jump up there. But underneath here, I wanted to show you, this is what I forgot about. Underneath here in this tote, we have all of our dishes stored up. And if you watch our video about dishes and the truck, that will give you more idea how those are stored. We have our cleaning supplies back here. So we have, this is our wash tub. Back there you can see, you know, some stuff sticking up. Those are our cleaning supplies, and there's our little Dirt Devil vacuum. So that's underneath the bed that's just stuck right underneath there. It's very easy to get to, slides in and out. You really don't have to move too much stuff around. And then if we flip it around, we forgot Lily Girl's food dish. So it's just right there. And you can find out more information about that and how we have our cute little fur baby in the truck. More information about her, check out her video. This is Lily, Trucker Dog Lily. All right, so that's a quick overview, guys, of how we've made our semi-tractor trailer, our Volvo, into a micro tiny house. So hopefully that gives you some ideas, some tips, some tricks that we've learned since we've been on the road as teams. Even if you're a single driver, I think this will be a big help to help you get organized. If you want to know more information about some of these things, like I said, go check out some of our other videos because there's definitely more details in that. So subscribe so you can see all the updated videos because every Friday we release a video and tell you some more tips, tricks, and trucker hacks. So enjoy the adventures, and until next time, bye. Give me my dreams.